I suggest you also grab your popcorn and keep that seat because up next is a game that keeps our players up at night. To practice, of course. Up next is Dota 2.
Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick. Radiant team pick.
Clockwork!
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Welcome back to Ucypher, ladies and gentlemen. It's Yodhas versus Yakshas in the second round robin of the season. Yodhas are going to be taking over the Radiant side while Yakshas will be handling the Dire. I'm Cloud X, with me is Vivek once again, and I for one cannot wait for this game to get started.
Silence,
yeah, the Yodhas have had a rocky start in round robin number one, but they're starting to find their form, and they're coming out as one of the stronger teams just yet in the tournament. The Yakshas, they're at the top. They've taken 11 points today, if I'm not mistaken. They were 60 last time around, and they're doing really well for themselves. I am so pleased to see the Spectre and the Medusa band.
Yeah, I couldn't be happier, man.
I'm going to give Akrid a hug after the game. I mean, excuse me, I'm going to give 11 a hug after the game. Akrid looks tense, actually.
Yeah, because Akrid has been relying on both the Medusa and the Spectre for the most part. We've seen him running these two heroes time and time again, but, you know, that's a player with a lot of lapis sleeves. We've seen him playing the Chaos Knight back in the heyday as well, and Chaos Knight has received a few buffs off late. I wouldn't be surprised to see them pick it up, especially now with the Earthshaker in their ranks. But two quick picks, it's going to be the Lich and the Earthshaker. They're all reverting back to the standard meta. Surprisingly enough, no one's picked up the Nightstalker.
Yeah, no one's picked up the Nightstalker. The Yakshas have actually opened the draft very smartly. They've banned out three of the most pesky heroes that the Yodhas do like to play often, the Spectre, the Medusa, and the Undying. And they've picked up VP's strongest hero in the form of the Clockwork. This time around, VP's going to be playing the Earthshaker, I presume. Lich going to be in the hands of... What? My bad.
I think you're in another time zone, man.
No, I mixed up the teams. I thought the Yodhas picked up the Clockwork. My bad. The Yakshas have still got VP his Clockwork. They have also got the Silencer for Punk.
You know, I think that happened because of the mismatch between the jerseys and the color of the Radiant and the Dire. So Yodhas who are red are on the green side, that's Radiant. So it's quite easy to get this mixed up.
Yeah, what happens when you put a green fish in the Red Sea?
It gets red?
Yes.
Third pick on the board, Yodhas. What are they going to go for? You've got the Templar and the Weaver banned out alongside that Undying. Yodhas, we've seen them bring a lot of different playstyles to the table, but I'm not sure if this Lich is going to be in the hands of 11 or if he's going to be running that 4 position again. If it is the 4 position 11, I want to see a Spirit Breaker coming out here once again. He's done a fantastic job so far on that hero. He's created a truck ton of space for his teammates. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. You might as well pick it up once more.
10 seconds remaining.
Yep. then you're saying that the Earthshaker goes to the offlane? Remaining.
Yeah.
If it is a four position speed breaker, okay. I mean, offlane Earthshaker is still not bad. He's one of those that can actually deal with where the creeps meet on the enemy safe lane. He could probably try and fissure block his own creeps and try and get the creeps under Slava, get EXP at the very least, hit 6 early on and hopefully have some impact in team fights. But you're going to see a Juggernaut getting picked up.
Not a terrible choice. Jug is one of those cores that's not too bad versus the Silencer. I'm assuming he's going to go rush the Manta style this game, and that would really help him hold his own. But man, Yakshas, they smell blood in the water with their Juggernaut pickup and immediately respond with the Axe. Another hero that's received a not-so-subtle buff as of the latest patch. He's got a talent that now allows him to proc counter Helix on auto-attacks, which really adds to his damage output potential towards the mid and late game stages.
What?
Yep, and let's not forget counter Helix.
Hold on, at what level does this talent kick in?
We'll find out in just a bit, but if I'm not mistaken, it's like a level 15 talent.
That's ridiculous. I mean,
let me double check that. But I know the point is, it's pure damage towards the late game phase, which is basically usable on command now. More or less on command. If I'm not mistaken, somewhere along the way, he's even got like a attack speed buff, attack speed talent or something of something such. Yeah, his level 10 talent is actually a choice between 8 strength and 40 attack speed. And then his level 20 talent is for attacks proccing counter Helix versus 20 health regen. Mm-hmm. So the late game fall off for Axe is no longer a thing. He does still continue to remain a source of extreme damage output in the area, in a massive area, or rather in a small area around him. Yodhas are going to go with their fourth pick here. They have only 30 seconds to take a decision and they are being pressed for time here. The fact is that Axe has thrown a wrench into their plans. What's the game plan here? I mean, do you revert to a mid laner that's got some range on him? Something that keeps his distance from the Axe? The problem is, even if you pick up something like a Sniper in the extreme case, you've got a Clockwork that can close the gap Radiant with the hook shot. And again, the Sniper's just going to be a sitting duck. You could go for something like a Necrophos, but they're going to go with the Legion. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm a big fan of this. Axe, Clockwork, both viable candidates for the Blademail. Blademail is something that works really well versus the Legion Commander, so I don't know. I'm a little worried for Yodhas with this Legion pickup. They're also lacking the ability to take any towers, and at this point, the only hero that can fill that gap in the middle lane is the Dragon Knight.
For the Yodhas?
Uh-huh. Team pick.
Four melee heroes then. It becomes very tempting for the Yakshas.
I think this Axe pick is just genius. It's come out when it was least expected. It's up against a tri-lane that the Axe can most definitely deal with. If things go south, Axe is possibly the best offlaner to just move into the jungle and deal with this stuff. They're going to go with the Sven as their fourth pick as well. So there's their source of absurd amounts of physical DPS. It's also a bit of bonus armor to deal with the physical deeps coming out from Juggernaut and Legion Commander. But it could be counterproductive because both the Axe and the Sven require the jungle in the mid-game stage. And that, I mean, it could cause some sort of an overlap if the Axe doesn't get a good start in the early stages of the game.
10 seconds remaining.
What do you think the Yodhas need in the mid lane? It's not a bad game for an Invoker.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I think the Invoker does check a whole bunch of boxes, including the tower takedown potential as well as the pick-off potential with the Sunstrikes. I guess the only deterrent for picking up the Invoker is the fact that there's a Silencer on the side of Yakshas, but that's something that can be dealt with an early Yule's pickup. Mm-hmm. Yakshas choose to ban the Viper. They don't want to give over any additional control versus that Sven. The best way to deal with the Sven is to either stunt his mobility or increase your own. No real mobile heroes on the side of Yodhas.
Game just got a whole lot out of for the Legion Commander. Also, possibly anyone the Juggernaut commits an Omni Slash upon.
I don't know though, this still seems a bit greedy coming out from Yakshas. Because both the OD and the Sven are heroes that need a fair bit of time to come online. And I mean, Yodhas have read this perfectly. They found the chink in the Yakshas armor. They know that the Pugna works fantastically versus the OD. And secondly, Pugna is a terribly good pusher. So they've checked off the box of the tower takedown potential. They've got themselves some counter initiation. Decrepify is fantastic versus the Sven. I don't know. I don't think this is going to be as hard a game for the Yodhas as we're making it out to be. I think they've got their bases covered. And if they play their cards right, they're going to come out through the gates charging and getting themselves towers. I was a little skeptical about that Juggernaut pickup because we talk about how Juggernaut is situational when you want to supplement a push. Now you've got the push coming out with the Pugna. You've got the initiation coming out with the Legion Commander. Counter initiation with the Earthshaker. And sustenance with the Juggernaut. So I think Yodhas has a really strong lineup here. Yakshas though. They've got a greedy lineup, but their lineup could pay huge dividends if only they get their space in the early and mid-game stage. But I think it's fairly safe to say that the Yodhas need to end in within the 30 to 40 minute mark, post which the Yakshas will probably have the upper hand.
Yeah, that's for sure. I mean, Acted will spin out of control. Appa, the more stats he gets, and if I'm not mistaken, he has a level 10 or 15 talent that gives him a little bit of HP or strength, not really sure. Going to become harder and harder to kill for just the Juggernaut, and Legion Commander really has to get up to one hell of a snowball sort of start if he hopes to stay relevant in the late game. If his mid game is lackluster, there's not much the Legion Commander
that
can do.
That snowball may not come through kills, it may come through tower takedowns. So a lot's riding on apps to get a good start in his lane as well. He's up against an OD, it's a matchup that the Pugna can most certainly deal with. I don't expect him to go for early points in the ward, but I would like to see some support coming in from the Earthshaker from time to time.
The battle begins. VP once again heading to that off lane to get that axe, that early boost. He's done it in the past when Khalnag was playing the center. He's going to try and do something similar this time around.
And rightly so, because this is a game where the Juggernaut tri-lane may not be able to kill off either Khalnayak or PP at level 1. The only real lockdown they've got is with that Earthshaker. While Earthshaker may be able to get a perfect Fissure block off, they don't have enough to hold them in position and let alone do enough damage with that Juggernaut Blade Fury. They're both strength heroes after all on the side of the Dire, and they're more than capable of holding their own here.
VP and Khalnag just walking in and taking this rune. 11 was chilling in the mid lane, didn't get that ward planted early on. So he doesn't really have any idea if the enemy mid lane has planted a ward just yet. Not the most ideal of starts. Yodhas end up losing a rune that they shouldn't have. It's Appa versus Apps in the mid lane. It's Yodhas versus Yakshas. This game cannot be more of a tongue twister. And I'm sure it's going to be a game with many twists and turns itself. But for now, Apps gets the better block. He's starting with a small advantage.
VP did plant down an observer ward deep behind the tower. I'm not entirely sure what that's for.
Yeah, I'm actually going to toggle Dire Vision, so it's not a good one. This is what it sees.
It's all right.
Are you expecting the LC to?
I don't think this is jungle? I don't think this is a bad ward, because it's likely that the LC will move into the jungle and the BP will be able to see him and come in for the cheeky sniper.
Hold on, is it a clear
it's
sniper?
There's also the fact that Apps could have support waiting in the trees next to him. That ward provides that valuable intel, and it's very unlikely that this ward is going to get dewarded as well. Anyway, how's bottom lane looking? Because that's where most of the action seems like it's going to take place. Shondi is sitting at 3 to 4 CS now. Axe is at 2 and 1. Akme's in the vicinity as well, but Khalnayak, he's got his level up now, and he's going to be able to put a point into that Berserker score. This is going to be a troublesome lane, to say the least, for Yodhas. Mm-hmm. Although this is going to help. They do get the D ward off on the side.
Yeah. Now life just became a little bit harder for Khalnag. Akme going into trade, 11 has the Frost Blast. They're going to force out consumables. They could look for the block. The Juggernaut though, he's busy dealing with the creeper. But they're going to force they're going to get the kill! What? I just thought they couldn't! Akme and 11 teaming up, scoring first blood. And Khalnag just overestimating his strength.
Axe just underestimating the damage output coming out from that Enchant Totem. Acme smacked him with two Enchant Totems, at least two Enchant Totems in that fight. Meanwhile, top, look at what's happening to Kale. He's about to lose his life.
Upon. He drops the Ironwood branch. He's going to block out VP, but they still got Vision and Punk.
He's also lost his intelligence. I mean, he's also taken away some intelligence from him. That's a bit of a nuisance. But yeah, the Axe Death on the bottom lane is super unconventional. Khalnayak just overstepping his boundaries there, not respecting the damage output coming out from Acme.
Yeah. I mean, the Enchant Totem doesn't stun without the Aftershock, but it's still a hard hit early on. Yeah.
There's also the fact that Lich had a point in the Frost Blast. Yeah. He got the level up courtesy that sacrifice bonus EXP. Frost Blast is magic damage, so even through the Berserker's Call, he took a lot of damage and he couldn't get too far away courtesy the slow. How's Apps looking in the middle lane? 6-2 versus 8-7. Appa seems to be taking the victory here in this lane.
Yeah, 7-9 is about playing the mid lane perfectly.
He's got a rather significant level advantage going for him as well. This is one of those lanes where magic sticks and magic wands prove to be so efficient on both the middle laners. The way that both middle lanes work is you want to spam your spells basically on cooldown. None of them really have mana problems, especially after Apps pulls out a bottle for himself and Appa gets a couple of levels in the Essence Ship. Anyway, folks, stay with us. There seem to be some technical hitches as the admins and folks get it sorted out. We'll be getting underway. Alright, here we go. Game's gonna get back underway. Apps didn't quite spot this earlier on out, but he does have a DD rune upon him, so this should tilt the scales of this lane slightly back in his favor.
Oh yeah, Apps, okay.
Appa. You don't want to be taking hits like this.
Yeah, this isn't too good, but he's got a salve and he's gonna try and soak as much damage as possible before he heals up. VP's looking for the rotation. He's searching for that level 2, might not find it with the Bounty Room. Has to try and find a lane where he can lead some EXP. Khalnayak, how's he looking? He's creeping with approaching his tower. But I think we might see a death on the LC once more. Accurate senses where he is and Kale's shown himself. His TP is on cooldown, the Arcane Curse upon him. He's not got to press the attack. He's taken a point in the overwhelming odds and VP just runs him down. He's now got the point in Cog. He's looking for the perfect opportunity to block Kale. And Punk is on the outside, dishing out that damage. And Kale just loses a little bit of intelligence and loses his life as well.
Yeah, Akrid gets the kill there. That's a little extra money going in his pocket. The intelligence going over to this Punk silencer as well. Good stuff coming out from Yakshas so far. They've got themselves a minor lead in terms of kills, but not much of a lead in terms of the net worth department. It's still the Yodhas that are commanding about 1,000 net worth in their favor and about 200 EXP as well. Most of this courtesy what the Juggernaut's been up to at the bottom lane. He's sitting at 20-12, while that Axe is just sitting at 2 CS right now. Khalnayak is level 2. Acme on the Earthshaker is level 3. Yodhas are absolutely dominating this bottom lane.
We
spoke about how imperative it is for the Axe to get that early start going for himself. He's going to be the tempo controller in the mid game. He's going to be the one that creates space for their greedy lineup. Unfortunately, Yodhas have read this game perfectly and they're stopping the hero that they need to stop the most.
Mm-hmm. Yodhas moving towards the mid lane. Secret, the blast one connects. Cross the turn around. He's got VP coming from the west. Apps needs to be careful. He's got supports nearby. The Fisher back again. Acme manages to clip the OD, but they're just looking for an opening here. But VP.
More interesting.
He's just moving towards the top. 11 has this time read that movement, and he's there as well. Kale caught with the Arcane Curse. The Storm Hammer expended. He's trying to survive and run away from this clockwork. 11 is here with the Frost Blaster. Press the attack might buy Kale some time. The Cog's not coming out just yet from VP, and he's moving towards 11. He's gonna kill that captain. The Cog's have been broken. The pushback is gonna click in. But the Storm Hammer will ensure that 11 falls first while VP gets away on nearly just 120 HP. Kale, he's trying to find a kill in response, but without any lockdown, it's unlikely that he will. Punk just racking up the intelligence, but Acme coming in for the Fisher. Kale needs a moment of courage, proc. It's not there. The Storm Hammer holds Kale in place, and VP's back for round 2. The overwhelming odds ensure that Kale gets a double. VP catches himself in the cogs and ends up going down. Beautiful stuff coming up from KL there.
Yep, KL. Fortune also played a big role in there because he walked in there not having the overwhelming gods. If at all they decided to jump him earlier on, they might have been able to get the kill without losing those two. But now Atric will be in trouble. The Fisher's on the wrong side. Acme, just slightly off point with that Fisher this time around.
Yeah.
But this works out well for the Yodhas once again. KO getting himself the double means that he got more than he lost.
VP might be punished. He's looking for the bounty rune. 11 committed the frost blast a little early while VP was still in the cogs. So it's not going to have the optimal effect, and VP just picks up a bounty rune and runs away.
Yeah, Acme had no mana either, so he couldn't attempt a Fisher there.
The wards have timed out. I mean, if ever there was a chance to gank the Pugna, it would be now.
Shondi, meanwhile, once again decimates the axe by himself, and Omni Slash seems to have been committed. And Khalnayak, he's already had a terrible game, it's only getting worse. Up top, meanwhile, Actrid getting stunned up. They've got him on the right side of the Fisher this time around. He drops the Stormhammer on two, with VP coming in with the cogs, blocking off three. They'll disengage this fight successfully. Or will they?
Kale wants to run in. He's hoping that the moment of courage procs. He's just going to dive. It did proc, but the damage not enough. And Punk, not the last word, won't be able to find the kill. Akme is still searching. He's not got mana, arcane boots on cooldown. He's got 6 charges though. And he's not going to get that enchant totem off. The cogs only hurt a little bit more. And 11, Akme and Kale could possibly go back and shrine if they want to.
Yeah, they're all running on reserve fuel right now. Akme, 11, as well as the Punk Silencer on the other side. None of them have any mana to work with. Kale's the only one that can dish out some damage and throw out some spells here. He's also got the infused raindrops for the bonus mana regeneration and the defensive layers kicking in, which will prove to be quite useful versus the Sven and that Stormhammer. Although Sven's chosen not to put extra points into it. He's just gone for the 1 point in Stormhammer this time around. Shondi, what's the up to? He's going for the drums first. They're relying on mobility and movement speed here to try and pull ahead. But without the Omni Slash, there's really not much you can do versus Khalnayak in the lane. Khalnayak's also picked up the Tranquil Boots, so pushing out the wave, going into the jungle and farming. This is when Khalnayak can start pulling back and making some sort of a recovery here.
Mm-hmm.
11. Got the Frost Blast available, but that's really all he's packing right now, and he could be a victim if he's not careful.
Akrid looking for that Storm Hammer. Kale nearby could dispel it with the press C attack. Kale just walking in, trying to bully this when Akrid turns around. He's got the guts and they've got to respect it, and Punk dishing out a lot of damage.
This is just like a Mexican standoff on the top lane. They're not really going for the kill, they're just burying their fangs
Fisher
at each other
though,
and backing
in the
off.
Bottom lane from Acme, possibly could set up a kill. Shondi has the Omni Slash Burst, no mana for it. He does have some stick charges. In fact, with the face boots, he's just going to run down Khalnayak. Acme looking for the enchant totem. Khalnayak pops the call, doesn't really catch anyone, and Shondi's going to run him down.
Easy kill there. Shondi getting the kill without committing the Omni Slash means that Acme can come back once again and score that kill on the Axe when he's back. I think Shondi's had a dream start here, but they need to convert this into a push. That's what their lineup is meant to do. They cannot get complacent just because they're winning the early game. They've got to pick up their socks, use this advantage, and make sure that they're taking towers on the back of these guilds.
Mm-hmm.
Else, you know for a fact that the Yodhas are going to slowly start to fall off. And you know that Akrid Sven is meant to farm in the mid-game if given the space. The only way that Yodhas can constrict that space is by taking out the first 3 towers on the front lines and moving into the jungle with those deep observer wards.
The Yodhas there was a little refreshed, but the die of their vision a bit lacking. I mean, they've only got this one ward looking over the bounty rune. They're not working with
Radiant's
too much vision
tower
for now.
Is under attack.
Maybe, I mean, he's kind of started to fall off in terms of EXP. Actually, he's been a lot more impactful. Kale just running in. He's got the duel, but without any bonus damage, not a chance that he wins it this early on versus this man.
Yeah, I think. To confirm a dual kill, he's gonna need the Pugna to make his presence felt up top as well.
Yeah.
With the blast and the life drain, they most certainly could bring down the Sven within one duel. But Pong is really close to level 6, and that'll be the full stop and the showstopper for the Pugna and the life drain as well.
Yeah. Do you think Pugna should possibly rotate towards the bottom lane and try and get a push start with Juggernaut? Juggernaut moves mid.
No, I actually think Pugna should move towards the top lane. That's exactly what he's doing as well, but For now, it just seems like he was going all the way to pick up a bounty rune, which is a fair bit of wasted effort versus an OD that's been out farming him in the lane.
Yeah, it's not like he had a bottle which could benefit from that bounty rune. Anywho, his wave was pushed out, probably had nothing to do in lane, just wanted to go pick up the bounty, and he's just going to make life difficult for the OD. OD does have the increased raindrops, so that Nether Blast doesn't do too much, but he's going to try and heal up with the life drain. TPs are coming in, his Acme might have the Fissure. The Fissure does connect, but they're not going to chase. A lot of poking and prodding coming up from both teams, not resulting in anything significant just yet. The real winner, if any, is Kale. And
VP. Kale and Shondi. Oh, both bottom.
Shondi just goes in with the Omni Slash, the Blade Fury as well. Shondi finding kill after kill. The OD TPs, though. Shondi cannot TP out. Apoch is going to run him down with the Arcane Orb. He doesn't have the Sanity's Eclipse. Shondi, his face boots pop. He's running into the trees. He's moved south while the OD's moved north, and he's going to get away.
That was a smooth escape coming out from Shondi, and a crucial one as well. And he's 3-0-0, and giving up that kill to the OD would have been devastating. But now, because the OD's not in the middle lane, Apps is going to get a tower on the top lane with the rest of his teammates, and he's going to make it back in time to the middle lane to prevent too much chip damage from taking place. This works out brilliantly for Yodhas.
Yeah. And what's a problem with Surf is that TP is not 6. And I also get the feeling coming in that he's maybe spending too much time finding utility. He didn't save the safe lane really. There was not much he could do to stop Kale. Kale got the kills he got.
They've also found Sven's stack here in the jungle and are stealing it away. 5 seconds till he can drop another overwhelming odds. But here comes VP looking at Acme behind. Acme, he drops the Fissure as well for good measure, and they only leave one Satyr Tormentor for the Sven to clean up later.
Yeah. Small but significant win, considering that there are no ancient stacks mid lane. Just a banner.
Apps is just
life draining app. He's trying to man fight, but the globe is silent from Punk. Apps really underestimating the silence player and getting punished. So Apps gets a kill.
You know, that's a global silence down for about 100 seconds now. And that means that the entirety of Yodhas could just group up and try and make something happen.
Push mid.
Why not? Kale is so close to his blink dagger though, so it's going to really prompt him to make a tough decision. Do we capitalize on this global silence by trying to push down a tower, or do we just hold on, let Kale get the blink dagger and then smoke? I think
just push mid.
I actually think the other option sounds better. Getting themselves that blink on Kale means that they might still have like a 50-second
window. Shondi's all by himself. Shondi's picked up a tower. VP without the hookshot can't really close the gap. He needs a sliver of EXP to get that hookshot going. They're moving up the slope. Kalank just backs off. He sees them all moving in his direction. Shondi goes in, kills VP. He's moving after Punk. Punk without the global silence is just a piece of meat. And with the chain frost, with the duel, they've got Appa control. They'll unload the Echo Slam. They bring down the OD. The partner is still alive. The healing ward on the floor. They can keep this push going all night long.
Well, Echo Slam wasn't actually unloaded there. He's still holding on to it.
Was that the Enchant Totem?
It was just the Enchant Totem with a smack to the face. But that works out brilliantly for the Yodhas. They end up walking away with 3 kills, a dual victory, and they defend their top tier 1 tower versus a God Strength pumped up Sven as well. Acrid is starting to fall really far behind at this point. I mean, as a free farming Sven, he's sitting a good 2,000 net worth behind that Juggernaut. The OD is doing okay for himself so far, but unfortunately, he's not having as much of an impact as they would like him to. And with every passing moment, Apps puts an extra point into that Nether Ward, which means that the OD has to be extremely judicious with the use of his spells.
Yeah.
And what's OD that can't use his spells?
So, how much mana do OD's spells cost? 100 mana for an Arcana?
It is painful. And it only gets more painful because each successive level of the Arcane Orb takes more mana up to a maximum of 160.
So has Kale picked up his blink? I think he's probably done. Yeah, he's got his blink.
Honestly,
dagger.
I don't think OD can fight up until he gets a BKB. He can't join the team fights until he gets a BKB unless they're 100% sure that they're going to take down that Nether Ward. Look at Apps, man. He just doesn't give a damn. Stands in his face and
Kalang goes in. He's got the call up for the Lich as well as the Pugna. The global challenge committed. VP running in. They've eliminated 11. Appa got the kill. Shondi pushed back by the cogs. The ward dealt with. A global challenge committed for just the Lich.
Not worth it.
Not worth it.
Totally not worth it.
I mean, especially since it's not resulting in an objective, but on the top lane, the duel is there. They've caught the Sven. Akrid is going to lose even more gold at this point.
And that's going to be Acme's blink dagger. 15 minutes in, you have a 4-position Earthshaker that picks up a blink dagger. This is not good news at all for the Yakshas.
Yeah. And they could keep pushing. They're dropping the Nether Ward in the mid lane. They know that the Sven is piss poor. Look for fights, look for objectives. What are they going to do? Their global silence is on cooldown. There's not much the Yakshas can do to really defend at this point.
Appa.
Oh, they're going in. But
life drain there, but no real damage coming out, or no real lockdown coming out as a follow-up. Earthshaker, unfortunately, not too close. But, I mean, this is really good sign. It's a good sign for Yodhas. They've still got a level pending on the Nether Ward, and already we've seen what kind of a force it can be if laid down in the middle of the battlefield. Khalnayak is thinking about blinking and initiating the fight here. I mean, there is an opportunity with Appa still having the Sanity's Eclipse available. It's two levels in the Sanity's Eclipse as well.
Yeah.
They're pinging out where Khalnayak could be. And they're gonna get this tower for free by the looks of it.
Good stuff coming up from the Yodhas here. 16 minutes in, they've got a 6,000 net worth advantage. They've taken down all tier 1 towers. Legion Commander has won his lane, or her lane, and also got 30 dual victory damage to her name.
Meanwhile, Shanli, he's going for the Manta Cell, which honestly is the ideal choice this game.
You want it versus the Silencer. I think he's almost got it done. He's missing a little bit gold and for the rest of the game. Shanli's also really good. How do the Yakshas find their way back into this game?
You wait for Appa to get the BKB. I think that's the only way you fight back. You get a BKB on Appa and you just focus on getting him some more levels with that Arcane Orb. He'll be dishing out a fair bit of damage in these fights.
Okay.
And I mean, they've got a lot of good initiation to go with it. A multiple hero call into a Sanity's Eclipse with a couple of hits from the Arcane Orb could devastate the front lines of Yodhas. But Yodhas are giving them no time whatsoever. Just gonna smoke up and move once again.
This
is making the
Yodhas vision of the axe, but they have a general idea that the Yakshas will get grouped up harming the jungle. The scan comes out from the Yodhas, doesn't clip anyone. They get a deep ward and they're grouping up and pushing a tier 2. This is more picks up coming up from the Yodhas.
Uh-oh.
Khalnayak.
Khalnayak could be in trouble here.
Khalnayak needs to be careful. Acting as a blink.
Oh, the wrong side.
Block, and Kayle even blinks in hoping to find the duel. But they don't get the duel. They should get the tier 2.
Yeah, and they'll lose nothing for it. I mean, the top tier 1, it's on a half HP. Akrid could pop the God Strength and try and make something happen, but I'm fairly certain that they're going to be carrying TPs on the side of Yodhas and they'll be able to go back to defend this.
All by himself, Nixon Observer Watch, scouting out the majority of the Yodhas.
Okay, Yodhas
coming in from VP, they break the healing ward, the global silence coming in, but he pops the Manta Cell, goes in with the Omni Slash, brings down VP. OD forced to Astral Herself, while Shandi hopes to Blade Fury and DP out. The call is there, but the chain cross upon that, the Fisher upon 2, the Sanity's Eclipse does nothing, the Echo Slam unloaded. It's a whole lot of damage upon the Yakshas. Akrid though, he wants the Earthshaker, and it looks like he might get him. Acme decrypted by the Pugna, and Apps with the Life Drain, but it's a Life Drain near a shrine, and Khalnayak goes in with call number 2. They might finally lose the Pugna. Where is the Legion Commander? Nowhere in sight, and Acme to fall as well. Khalnayak with the call, with the dunk. No lockdown for 11, unfortunately. Khalnayak's call was a little bit off the mark, if I'm not mistaken.
I'm not entirely sure where Kayle was throughout that fight. I think he TP'd up top to deal with the threat of the Sven taking a tower, but Sven decided it's better for him to go in and take the fight instead.
Yeah.
Shandi, full points for style there. He does manage to turn it around and get a freebie on the clockwork, but that fight goes poorly for the Yodhas.
So,
and I think Akrid and the boys will be happy with that.
They will, but it's kind of a little indecision amongst the Yodhas. They went looking to probably catch the Yakshas. OD had invis. OD used the Astral, they committed the global. Shandi got a kill and TP'd out of there. B, Kayle was not there. But they unloaded their ultis and didn't get anything done.
I mean, that was picture perfect from the Earthshaker and the Lich, right? They got a Chain Frost out in the middle of nowhere. The entire Chain Frost hit the heroes, except for one bounce, which probably went on a neutral creep. The Echo Slam caught 2, but they just couldn't make anything happen. But now, Akrid, in a world of trouble, they're just running straight at him. But Kayle blinks to the right side, and Akrid runs to the north.
Khalnayak doesn't want to go in, though. here as well. So, I think the Yodhas would do better to just group up and push once they have some altitude. The last fight should have been a disengage after they got that kill on VP, but they still decided to fight either way without the Juggernaut. Sondi's here this time around. He's got the Manta style. The Global Silence is on cooldown.
It's back. I mean, the fight's basically been reset. The only absentee is the Echo Slam on the side of Acme.
Yeah, it's gonna be up in 25. But they're gonna push.
You know, there's a little bit of paranoia setting in for VP as well. He's choosing to go for the Ghost Scepter first instead of the Blade Mail. Just fearing for that Juggernaut who's ripping him a new one time
I'm
and again.
I'm sensing this is one of those games where VP's gonna feel a little useless because the Pugna's picked up his 4-star. It's gonna help him. It might also help the Earthshaker or the Lich if they get jumped upon. There are a lot of factors and a lot of items that sort of make the Clockwork feel useless.
Yeah. But, I mean, the Ghost Scepter is not bad, but it's the cop-out. It's the defensive way of dealing with the Juggernaut and the Legion of Murder.
Yeah.
The Blade Mail would be the more manly approach, but that doesn't really help you versus the Omni Slash.
And coming up from the Dire near the Rosh Pit, they sense that the Yodhas could possibly be wanting to go Roshan. The Yakshas have smoked up there, holding the high ground. And now the Yakshas can. And the Yodhas can. Both teams scanning each other out. They pretty much know where they are. The question is, how do they decide to move with this information? The Rocket does manage to clip most of them. The Yodhas backing off and they got his smoke. 11 does have one. They're grouping near the tier 1, looking to pop the smoke. It's going to be a game of initiation and pure team fight for the next couple of minutes. Acme leading the charge, looking for the Fisher, possibly the Echo Slam. VP's Rocket doesn't scout anything, and the Yakshas, they're backing out. Funk has the Global Silence, but Acme is on by himself.
He's a bit vulnerable,
just slings the hell out of that. Acme blinking in. This could be the perfect Fisher, and it pretty much is. Kale goes in with the duel. The TP is yet to come. The Global Silence not committed, but the Astral is there. It buys the Swen some time, but a character blinks. Yes, he can.
What? 11?
Shondi moved away. Didn't have the great fury to cancel the blink, and 11 just unloaded the Chain Cross. Kalek goes in for the call. Ends up catching the air, but VP with the hook shot. He's caught Shondi in position. A quick Fisher from Acme to secure his retreat while Akrid rejoins the fight. Looking to
no,
blink
in. What are you doing, Shondi?
Kalek could go in. Kalek has the call, but his blink's been disabled. Those Manta illusions continuously attacking the axe, ensuring that his blink was cancelled.
That was too close.
That was close. They only used the Chain Cross, and unfortunately, they didn't win or lose the duel.
Good save coming out from Appa there on that, on the Sven. That was really the game changer for the most part in that last fight.
Yeah.
Kalnayak did attempt a call on the high ground, but he hesitated for a moment. I think that's the reason why the Earthshaker, or was it the Legion Commander, that managed to TP out. No one ends up dying in that fight. Both teams just end up expending their smokes for nothing. The only difference is Yodhas continue to push out the bottom lane now. Mm-hmm. And with the pressure being applied on the tier 3, they could move into the Rosh Pit and claim the Aegis. There is a decent observer ward placed down by the Yakshas though.
Yeah.
Near the Rosh Pit. That's going to provide a lot of valuable information. And if I'm not wrong, we should be out of smokes on the side of Yodhas as well. It's unlikely that they're going to get past that ward without being spotted.
And it's almost as if VP heard you and decided to queue up the angel of the drop by quick bite.
Real men by Blade Mail.
Real men by Blade Mail. The lag won them.
Well, the lack of smokes on the side of Yodhas may be a factor here against them, but Yakshas, they've got their final smoke here, which they're going to pop and go on the hunt. Global Silence is online, literally all of their ults are online. They can attempt to make a big team fight and transition it into either a Rush takedown or a tier 1 at the mid, or heck, maybe even both, depending on who they kill.
They found really cool with the Rosh Pit and the takedown Roshan. 11 is trying to keep tagged. He might bump into VP. VP stops the battery assault. 11 by himself doesn't. He does have the Chain Cross, while VP hookshots into the Pugna. The immediate Global Silence ensuring that there's no layer of defense keeping the Pugna alive. And Appa pounds away on 11. The Omni Slash wasted on the OD, but Shondi with that Blade Fury might be able to bring down the Axe, while Kale with the duel ensures that VP dies. Acme with the Echo Slap, with the Fisher. He's caught three. The Nether Ward is still there. Akrid is trying to man up, but Shondi is more of a man, especially when he's got Kale by his side. They bring down four. Beautiful play coming out from Acme there. Picture perfect Echo Slam.
Beautiful play coming out from the entirety of Yodhas, yeah. Actually. That looked like a fight that was only going downhill with the death of the Pugna and the Lich at the start. That was essentially a 3-5 fight. That was 3-5 and they ended up coming out on top.
Yeah, it was 3-5. The Lich went down. VP did the best thing he could. He got the Lich and the Cogs, if I'm not mistaken, and hookshot it onto the Pugna. The Global Silence came out. They jumped on top of the Pugna, focused him down. And then Acme, along with Kaelin Shondi, pretty much salvaged the fight.
I think the confidence from Shondi to come in from behind and start the fight with the Omni Slash was...
VP, what are you doing?
He was trying for the hookshot Aegis Steel, but the respawn time was too low.
Acme. This should be a kill. His 4 stops on cooldown. You can lift your arm. You can stammer as much as you want, but there's not much you can do. The Rocket Fly's gone into the pit, but Kalang's Blink is being cancelled by the Chain Frost. Appa goes in, YOLO, Shondi picks up the Aegis. It's not a snatch, this means the Radiant even managed to get that extra goal. The duel nearly comes in, Kalang goes in for the call, but he's disarmed by the Decrypt, blasted down by the Nether Blast, and sucked out with the Life Drain. Shondi goes in, huge cogs coming out from the Yakshas, but it pretty much ensures that only they themselves are caught in the cogs and they run back to the shrine, missing an axe.
Even Acme doesn't die there, by the way. So he was being chased by the clockwork. He got the enchant totem off, turned around with the fissure while the battery assault ran out, and then he managed to bail with the blink. Clockwork not really having the best time here. His lack of a blade mail is actually hurting.
I don't understand that.
Battery assault basically ran out at the tail end of it as he got up onto the high ground over here.
So what, the cogs turned out, he hit an enchant totem and got away?
He got an enchant, turned for the fissure, and then he ran. So they got absolutely nothing.
That hurt.
Whereas Yodhas got an Aegis. They got a kill on the axe. And they're basically now looking to push once again. As soon as the Omni Slash is back, it's back.
The Omni Slash is back. They got the Echo Slam, Duel. Pugna's picked up the Kaya as well. And Lich has the Chain Frost in
6 seconds. What's worrisome though is that Shondi is considering going for the Skadi right after the Manta and the Blink. He's not going to be dishing out enough damage by the looks of it. He probably wants to get a slightly more offensive item. If you're looking for a bit of defense, the Butterfly is the item of choice.
Right.
I don't think you go for the Skadi.
I think if you're looking for offense and some cheap defense, you go for the Abyssal.
Yeah, Abyssal is not half bad either. It's between the Abyssin and the Butterfly. I don't think the Skadi is there. Either way, they are in an advantageous position now with about 10,000 net worth swinging in their favor, 10,000 EXP as well. Shondi with the Aegis, comfortable and confident sitting on the front lines like this.
Yeah, ice armor upon him. He's not got too much armor because it's only a level 2 ice armor, but enough to start pushing with the Nether Blast. They're going to take down the last outer tower. VP running away from the team.
Oh, that ward's tagging him. They know that the OD is standing up there on the cliff now.
App actually moves further east to just kill that last center. But yeah, they're going to give up the tier 2 without any contest. They're going to try and hold on to the high ground. And this is Kalnayak's time to shine, if any.
Yeah, he's got to make the big plays.
Haven't yet seen too impactful of a call just yet.
Yeah, 10 seconds, then Nether Ward is back. But the next creep wave is a long way out here, near the tier 1 tower, actually, so. I don't think they're going to be able to take this tier 3 as easily as they would like, but they will be able to do chip damage.
They got the Nether Ward back again.
That ward is placed rather offensively, by the way. Almost as if it's bait.
Absent for the Blink for
Look at what VP is doing, by the way. This is such a high-risk play coming out from VP, but one that could pay massive dividends
if
they play their cards right.
So he's got to stop the fight tonight.
He's got to stop Acme from coming in, basically. And he's in the right position to make that happen.
But if he throws off one stray rocket, they'll know as to where he is. Yeah, now they know. They know. Meanwhile, mid lane, Acme, he's going in upon Shondi. He's tier 3 under siege. Battle Hunger shrugged off by the pesky attack. VP still looking for an opportunity to go in.
Acrid popped the God Strength over there, and now they know. So they're just going to wait it out and then come back in to finish what they started. Now, how do you defend without the Sven's God Strength? You rely exclusively on Appa to dish out the pain. If Appa gets caught with a duel here, there's nothing to stop him. There's nothing to stop Kalnayak from just decimating him by himself.
Yeah, how are you dealing with Shondi?
There's the ward placed down.
VP started giving up. I mean, no. He moved further towards the east. Well, they're sieging and they're doing it right so far.
Shondi. Another 8 seconds till he can Blade Fury once more. In fact, I wouldn't be too against Shondi just breaking in and starting with the Omni Slash right now. You know for a fact that there's no God Strength, but that window is closing slowly but surely.
Yeah.
A And once they've got the god strength online again, they might consider fighting. Akrid's mighty close to his BKB as well. Here we go though. Call starting things off. Khalnayak pulling Juggernaut all the way back towards the tier 4, but he just blinks right back to continue his onslaught on the melee.
Okay, that's the time you want to go in. The Manta popped, the global silence to follow, but the lockdown is in there. Kale with the perfect call. Excuse me, the perfect duel. Right on top of the OD. And Akrid once again! This guy GH God on a smurf. He unloads the mother of all Echo Slams, and Kale goes on cleanup duty. Akrid without the God Strength is just a piece of meat, and the life drain will ensure that Apps will be able to suck away a lot of HP from Appa. Shondi with the Omni Slash brings down the Axe. It's a buyback from Khalnayak, and Shondi is moving on to the OD. Enchant Totem coming up from Acme. The Astral to buy some time. Khalnayak, he's bought back. His calls on cooldown. He's trying to bring down the Earth Shaker while Shondi is going to beat a hasty retreat. Finally, the Earth Shaker goes down, but there's a hole in the base. The lane of Barracks mid have fallen. Apps is low. He's got to back off for a bit. I don't mind the Yodhas falling back and regrouping and coming once more.
Yeah, they can't end the game right away. They've got to back away for a bit, come back with refreshed items, HP and mana. And they've got to go shopping, basically. You've got the top three heroes in network on the side of the Yodhas. The Juggernaut on top, Legion Commander behind him, and soon after him is the Pugna. What's the item choices here? You've already got the Aghanim's Kaya and the 4-star finished up on the Pugna. He's basically capping out right now. Juggernaut, he's still got the Skadi queued up, but I'd like to see him switch things up and get a Butterfly and Abyssal Blade here. Well, the Legion... I still think the Butterfly is really high value here versus... the Evasion works versus the Arcane Orbits. Okay. It also works versus the Sven, so...
Yeah, lockdown is not a problem.
Dire's bottom if he stays alive and under attack.
Works with that high agility in the armor.
But it's not over just yet. It's definitely not over just yet. I mean, we know for a fact that the Yakshas lineup is fantastic in the ultra late game phase. We know that it's a greedy lineup and one that could benefit if given the time to come online in its entirety.
Okay.
One lane of super creeps is not enough. The Sven is more than happy to clean them up every now and then. The Axe is pretty good at that as well.
They've got to do this again. The question is, are they going to allow a run to take place? Are they going to allow the Sven to farm? Are they going to wait for the next one run? Or do they just go with the items they have?
I think you take out the shrines and possibly go for the next ages before doing anything.
Okay,
cheap.
So you wait for the shrine.
Oh no, Shondi. Too close for comfort there. He blinks out by the skin of his teeth, and Observer Ward was watching him as Khalnayak was making his way as well.
Well, they're not gonna wait for this one. Apps has the Axe Scepter, so there's non-stop life to be drained there.
Shondi did go for the Skadi after all though. He's got the bonus frost armor kicking in upon him as well, so he's really tanky at this point, but he's still killing him. I guess the Skadi works versus the OD. I mean, it's a little bit of intelligence to reduce the damage that comes out from the Sanity's Eclipse multiplier. That's the only explanation I can think of for him going for the Skadi here, but...
Okay.
That assumes that...
The tier 3 is falling. Khalnayak has to go in. Press the attack, Blade Fury. What are they waiting for? Are they hoping for VP to start the fight? Then they might as well just start the fight with VP. Khalnayak, he's still not got that Shadow Blade, and I think you got to start saving for buyback. You either go all in and run the risk of losing the game, or you just save for buyback. They've gone in on Shondi, the call is there, but where's the follow-up? VP with a hookshot down. Where is Akrid? The immediate global silence is there. I think they're trying to bring down Shondi. No, wait, there's the Echo Slam from Acme. They managed to bring down Akrid instead. The Fisher clips on too, the Chain Frost bouncing around. Khalnayak is life drained out of him. And GG, well played his call. 26-11 is the call. The Yakshas take their loss with grace. The Yodhas are simply the better team to win.